Element 4, right?
It was at the end of Element 4.
Isn't that right there?
I believe that was it. So I'll double check the most recent version. Okay. I was under that impression from the last week. But yeah.
The entire paragraph back in the
next one. Okay. I think that's pretty much it. I have a couple other things, but I'll try and I'll email that so we can speak. Thank you.
I don't have students here yet, but I will soon. But I just wanted to follow up on what Sharon was saying. It seems as though the main concerns for most of these parents who have stakeholders is in the governance section. And I've heard both of you ensure us that that's not going to change. It's going to run exactly the way it has been. And the only reason that you did change it was because you had a training with Dr. Carpenter, and that he said to do that. And with all due respect, Dr. Carpenter is not a stakeholder in this community. And if this concerns enough people and enough of the stakeholders that you can leave it as a status quo because it hasn't been working, maybe that would be the best thing to do. And I would recommend that to the board. Thank you.
First of all, I'm not eloquent, and I stutter when we get worked up, but I'll try. Okay. What you said, ditto everything. Okay. I agree with her. All of her concerns, it seemed like the issue of the class sizes, it seemed like that just got whitewashed. Just like, well, we can't do it, so we'll just write it differently. Maybe they wouldn't want this. The other thing, I'm with you. I want to speak to you. You said, I'm like, those are my same questions. The charter, all people that wrote the charter had a vision, and if it's working, which I think it is, then the question again, why change it? I don't have all the pages and the sections written down. But when I read it, I noticed that a lot of the strikeouts were governing board were crossed off, executive director in all the circumstances. So that makes it seem like he is all of that and not the board anymore. And then my other thought is when you're saying the board was involved in all of this writing and everything, I want to know which board that was. The board before all the hoopla or the board now? And my other question is, these are just silly things, but you know, I want to know, what does close the achievement gap mean? And the other thing I want to know is, because you mentioned the satisfaction survey results as being quite glorious. I want to know, was that a standard survey or was that a custom written survey? Because I looked at it and I would not take it because I thought it was slanted. And I really think that I want to know, is that a standard survey that all schools get the same or was it written to derive a certain result?
The survey questions you pull from different surveys, they're kind of standard questions. You look at 20 surveys and you say, okay, here's questions that come from our charter petition, here's questions we want feedback on. So it's a combination of questions you pull from different surveys. So hopefully that answers that. In regards to other questions?
Some of the questions specifically in the survey come straight out of
some of them not, some of them.
I just felt like there weren't enough options in the answers. And I thought the only options that were available would either put it way off this way or way the other way. And I can't even remember what was in there now, except it was just really, but yet you're using it in here to build, you know, the good looks of the school. So that's just my
opinion. I wasn't the one who wrote the questions, but it certainly wasn't the intent to skew any information, and it was an actual requirement to conduct surveys.
Well, I know you have to conduct them. That's why I know. Were the questions asked, you know, so that people wouldn't have to think too much or something? Can't get that straight. Well, it really isn't, but there's really nothing there for me to get. But anyway, I won't carry on about that. My main concern is that I think the school was running fine before, you know, it started getting messy. And I'm not a union person. I'm not pro-union at all. I think unions, for the most part, are terrible. The more union is terrible, I think a lot of those unions are terrible. I wish you'd be a union. And so I support that. And I love all the teachers here. I work very closely with a lot of them, and I think they all care a lot about the kids. And I just want to quote something that is in okay. I just want to read this one little part that I pulled out of that verbiage there. It said something on 14:15. It said, the mandate of the Big Brothers High School Board is to promote and maintain the guiding mission the government structure is designed to foster participation by all stakeholders and assure the effectiveness of local school control and accountability. As part of the CBCH mission, it is vital that students witness and participate in CBCH's collaborative process of policy development and decision making. I kind of like to know what you have to say about that. That the students should witness and participate in the school's collaborative process of policy development and decision making. And part of what made me notice that is last year when teachers were being accused of discussing the situation with the students, how are the students not going to know if they don't hear about it?
So we had a lot of students involved in our process for a year, and so lots of students participated where we formulated our whole goals for the next 5 years, our strategies, our academic strategies, our academic plan, our loss management plan, our intervention plans, things that were some monies were spent towards, a lot of things were
okay.
Students also participated, at least the big ones, I think we are student services committee. Reps that come to PLC, student clubs, and department clubs, you know, kids are involved in some kind of club. There's a whole lot of student participation. So I'm just saying, you know, you should help me out, I'll shoot for me out.
Yeah.
You know, some of your comments are a little condescending.
Pardon me?
Some of your comments are a little condescending.
Mine?
Yeah.
Okay.
So where we have surveys, where we're gathering parent opinion, I really disagree with you that that's not valuable information. That's very valuable information. We read the data very closely. It's us soliciting parent response, parent guidance. We go through each of the combined data for each question on that survey to measure where we can improve. So again, I take that stuff very seriously. You do or not? That's what
I do. No, I do take it seriously if I feel like my opinion